Hey, it's Kaylee, and in this video, we are going to be introduced to area multiplication by playing with a simulation. After we play together, you get to play on your own. Let's get started. Here we are in the home screen to the area model multiplication introduction. We're going to start with the multiply box. So we click in here and we see that we have a grid of squares. And on the sides here, it tells us the dimensions of the colored in square. So to start, I'm going to unclick this counting box. So now it's unchecked. And as you recall, area is how many of these colored squares are taken up. So here it looks like I have one, but if I go like this, now I have a lot more. But let's start small. So here we are, we have a box of 2 by 2 dimensions, and it shows us over here that we have factors 2 and 2. And remember, area is multiplying our factors together, so we get an area of 4, which is the same as how many boxes are colored in. So now if we check this handy little box here, it counts the boxes for us. So when we make it a bigger box with too many to count, we can see that our area is going to be equal to 10 times 10. Those are our factors, or the length of the sides of our colored in area, which is 10 times 10, which is equal to 100, which is how many little boxes there are. So you can play around with this by taking this green circle and dragging it anywhere you want on the grid. And when you stop, you can find the area by multiplying your height times your length, your factors, or by counting the boxes. And you can unclick the counting box to make it harder. So now you'd have to do 8 times 9. Those are my factors. If I multiply them together, I get a product of 72 for my area. So you can play around here, and then we go back to the home screen, and now we get to learn another tool called the partition. So if I click in here, you'll see again I have a grid, and I can make my box. So my colored in squares are my area. Right now it tells me 5 times 5. Those are the lengths of my sides. My area is equal to 25. But there's another trick here where you can take this red triangle and you can drag it out so that you could make your give yourself easier math to do. So if I put my partition here, now I have 2 rectangles. I have one that has dimensions of 5 and 3, and I have another one that's dimensions 5 and 2. So now I could take this 5 by 3 product, and I would have 5 times 3 is 15. If I add my partial products in, I get 15 for this one, and I'd get 10, 5 times 2 for this one. And then I add those two areas together, so 15 and 10, and I would get 25. So this is really helpful when you have bigger areas with numbers that are harder to multiply together, like 9 and 9. But if I move my partition over to something like 4 and 5 or 6 and 3, now you might have an easier time doing 9 times 6 plus 9 times 3, which should be 81. And so you can play around with these here. You can also open up the calculation button here, and it will help you make sense of your partition. So if we go back to a harder one, how about 8 times 9. So I have a big box, 8 times 9, but I can slide my partition out to, let's see, I like 4 and 5 multiplications. So I could see that 8 times 9 is equal to 8 times 4 plus 8 times 5, which gives me my 2 rectangles, this 8 times 4 rectangle plus this 8 times 5 rectangle, which gives me 32 plus 40. And if I add those together, I get my total area of 72, which is also equal to 8 times 9. So go ahead and play around with these, and you can get the hang of area model multiplication. Have fun, and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.